us. Hey, Mario! Remember us?
No.
You used to come in every day.
So where you been? We're tanking here.
Two slices and two grape sauce.
Oh, thanks. That'll save us.
I'm making the large sodas.
Hey, Jerry, the Frogger?
Used to be so into this game. Hitting that frog across the street was my entire life.
Then you went on to. That's a good game.
What's a trick? How you jump? Eat the fly! Eat it!
Thanks a lot.
Happy to talk.
It's more GLC. George Louis Costanza, that's not you, is it?
Yes! 860,000! I can't believe he's still standing! The Hornets beat me like 10 years!
I remember that night!
Oh, I was on!
Stop!
The perfect combination of mountain and mozzarella. Just the right amount of grease on a joystick. You should beat some pea brains.
I think I remember why we stopped coming here.
Is it too late for me to go to law school? What is this?
You were out sick yesterday, so we got you a get well cake.
It's carrot. It's good for you.
Get well soon. We wish you to get
well. It's not even a song. I mean, now we're celebrating the sick day?
I think it's nice.
What? What is nice? Trying to fill the void in your life with flour and sugar.
Truck. GLC must live on.
website, that small college boy Vinny Fooch, is my latest acquisition. A slice of cake from the wedding of King Edward VIII to Bola Simpson, circa 1937. Price, $29,000.
Dutch country.
Oh, that's
a little more time. See how it looks in the light of day.
So I don't accidentally toss it in that dumpster.
I'll meet Dan at your place, 15 minutes.
A long, long weekend.
I hear thee.
Elaine, excellent. I'd like you to meet a friend of mine, Erwin Lubeck.
Hello?
Charmed. All right. Brace yourself, Lubeck. You are about to be lost. Was on the receiving end of one of the oldest baker's grift in the books. The Enterman's ship. Until I remembered the videotape surveillance system that I installed to catch other water using my latrine. But it also caught this.
Hey,
in an English basement?
I guess I hadn't.
Well, I have a feeling what you are about to go through is punishment enough. Dismissed.
I was screaming at hecklers all night. Last time I opened for a rodeo.
Well, Derek, I've been thinking. You know, as far as I can go with George Costanza.
Is this the suicide talk or the nickname talk?
George, what is that? It's nothing. It's got no snap, no zip. I need a nickname that makes people light up.
You mean like Liza?
I was thinking.
T-bone. But there's no T in your name. What about G-bone?
There's no G-bone.
Is it G-spot?
That's a myth.
T-bone, the ladies are gonna love you.
Why did they hire you for a rodeo?
They heard I opened for Kenny Rogers once.
Didn't he throw you off a bus in the middle of Alabama?
Oh, I had that coming to me.
Whoa.
Did you get me?
You don't have to whisper. She knows she's a man.
I hired her from a service.
All done.
Thank you. Nice job.
This is mine?
Yeah.
Jerry, you didn't notice?
Notice what? She's not really even a maid. She wants to be an actress. Or a model. Or a dancer. Or a
newswoman.
Bad news, boys. My life is over. My girlfriend's moving away.
You have a girlfriend?
Jerry, where have you been?
At a rodeo. Where's she moving?
Downtown.
Downtown New York?
Yeah. I don't know if I can handle one of these long-distance relationships.
It's like 10 minutes by subway.
Are you okay?
Come on, it's a whole different world downtown. Different Gap, different Tower Records. And she's a 646.
What? What is that?
That's the new area code. We've run out of 212, so all the new phone numbers are 646.
Huh. I was a 718 when I first moved here. I cried every night.
Listen, heads up, Elaine. I'm going to have to stop by later and pick up a fax.
At work?
No, at your apartment.
I don't have a fax machine.
Here we go.
Now what are we going to do? See, this is why you should get a fax and a Xerox and a deadbolt. Are you sure you don't have one? Because there's a lot of stuff in my apartment I've never seen.
Then maybe you have a fax machine.
You just blew my mind.
Let's order lunch. Mary, I will have a chef salad.
Turkey sandwich.
T-bone steak.
For lunch?
Well, I am just a T-bone kind of guy.
Love that T-bone.
In fact, you might as well call me.
It sounds good. I'll have one too.
What? Did you have a T-bone?
I love them.
Well, then we should call you T-Bone.
No, we shouldn't.
T-Bone.
decision.
Elaine, do you think I would go willy-nilly into a situation so obviously fraught with potential complications?
You're paying a woman to come to your house and sleep with you.
No, I pay her to clean. The rest is...
What? A health plan?
I was going to say being a good host. But the point is, we have our personal relationship and we have our work relationship. They're separate and I think somewhat sophisticated.
So you consider this a relationship?
Yes, I do.
Have you been out?
Yes, we have.
Where did you go?
The store.
To get what?
Stuff.
Cleaning supplies?
And gum.
Well, there's nothing more sophisticated than diddling the maid and then chewing some gum.
She's not a maid. She might be a nose woman.
Yeah. Well, I just saw Madeline off. Yeah, she's in a cab and on her way. I miss her already.
Hey, Kramer, when was it you were having faxed to my house every 30 seconds?
Well, I signed up for a food delivery service. And now we're cooking. It's a play on words. They're faxing me the menus from some restaurants.
Which ones?
Well, all of them. Yes, a deluxe package.
So this is never gonna stop?
Well, better not. Paid for the whole year. So should I pick those up later?
You can pick them up right now.
Here's your new number.
646? What is this?
That's your new area code.
I thought 646 was just for new numbers.
This is a new number.
No. It's not a new number. It's just a change number. See, it's not different. It's the same. Just changed.
Look, I work for the phone company. I've had a lot of experience with semantics, so don't try to lure me into some maze of circular logic.
You know, I could have killed you and no one would have known.
I could have killed you and no one would have known.
Kramer, you're still on the phone?
Madeline and I are watching Quincy together.
Jerry, you know this comes out at the same time here as it does there?
Really? It's Tuesday here. What day is it then?
Jerry's teasing. Oh, commercial. Are you going to the bathroom? Yeah, I'll go too.
Madeline stays here. Hey, T-Bo!
No T-Bo.
No T-Bo?
Right here.
Thank you. Watch out for that maroon goal.
This guy's
Jerry, you know who the Grand Marshal is of this thing? None other than Miss Chita Rivera.
Man, my hand is out. I think we're gonna need more than a hand. I have to see a human face.
Sure you want his face?
Soda guy. side. Yeah, wouldn't it just bounce back and forth between your cornea and the mirror? Faster and faster, getting more and more intense. The blood. It's in your eye now. Actually, this room intrigues me. Why is it called the TV room? Look, how is that a bomb? Do you have any snacks?
Mr. Barnson, if you'd like the apartment, I should tell you. I also have some interest from a wealthy industrialist.
Any backer. I wish I didn't. Brace yourself, madam, for an all-out bidding war. But this time, advantage Barnson!
The factory.
Saab factory.
Jerry, that's insane.
Watch this. Shut up!
his whole life as a fantasy kid. People should punk down $2,000 to live like him for a week.